Hi guys, it's Toddy here from Rokomu at a London pre-briefing for the newly unveiled Samsung Galaxy S8 and S8 Plus. And in my right hand, I am holding the S8 Plus, the larger of the two new devices, the new flagship from Samsung. In my left hand, I'm holding the Galaxy S7 Edge, obviously last year's larger flagship from the two S7 series phones. And I thought I'd put them side by side so you know exactly what the differences and similarities are between both the S7 Edge and the S8 Plus. Now, aside from the name, both phones do feature a lot of things in common, and I will cover those first, starting with the screens. Both feature high resolution Super AMOLED displays with dual curved edges. That means that the edges of both phones curve off at the sides, they look near bezel-less. The effect is even greater on the new S8 and S8 Plus. It is absolutely stunning. And as you might be able to tell, especially at the bottom of the S8 Plus's screen, the corners are now rounded, so it's more natural looking. It's still a 6.2-inch display, like I said, so it's a bigger screen than the one found on the S7 Edge. But they've also upped the resolution, so from the 2560 by 1440 screen on the S7 Edge, which is an absolute stunner, arguably still one of the best displays on the market, the resolution for both S8 and S8 Plus is now 2960 by 1440 in a Quad HD. It's a 18.5 by 9 aspect ratio rather than a 16 by 9 aspect ratio. That taller, wider profile means that when you turn the phone into landscape, it actually is better suited to watching movies and things shot in widescreen because there's less pillar boxing or letterboxing or anything of that sort. You just get more content on the screen and it just looks that little bit sharper and greater. Also, Samsung's pushing the fact that you get about 18% more height in this phone versus the S7 Edge and the S8 to the S7, which means that you have better, more room for multitasking. The example that they use is that you had a near full screen app if you were using an S7 Edge, but with additional space on top playing a video in kind of the full width of the phone. I believe it's about 400 pixels tall. So it's a really nice feature to have just by having that extra screen size. Another thing you'll notice is that there's no longer a physical home button on the S8 Plus. The home button here on the S7 Edge features a fingerprint sensor, and then either side of it are capacitive keys which are backlit. Now, they've all gone on screen in the S8 Plus, and instead the fingerprint sensor is now on the back of the phone, up by the camera arrangement. So it's a lot like some of the other phones you've seen from the likes of Huawei, and even like the Nexus phones from days gone by as well. So I think a rear-mounted fingerprint sensor is arguably a more convenient place for it, just because it just your hand naturally wants to sit up there too. Now, whilst we're on the front here, if I turn to the sides, both phones feature rounded metal frames as well and rounded metal backs. They look great. Equally, like the build quality is pretty great on both of them. They're both IP68 certified, I should say, so they retain that water and dust resistance with the new S8 Plus and S8 over the S7 Edge and S7. But you can see the volume rocker here is now a single button on the S8 Plus, and there's also an additional button. The power button's on the other side of the phone, so this button is the Bixby button. In this particular model we're using, we can't show you the full functionality of Bixby because it comes to the UK after the US and Korea. But one thing it does do is effectively it mixes together. I don't believe this phone has Update switched on right now. But the S8 Plus has Bixby screen, which has got Update news. It also has your fitness, your diary, weather, news. It puts everything in one place. In addition to that, it has this feature called Bixby Vision, which is a completely new feature that the S7 Edge lacks altogether. It means you can do things like take a photo of an object and it can scan it and find it online, or you can find it for retail, or you can find a place by shooting a picture of a landmark and it'll tell you about that area. The voice element, which is coming later, as I said, will effectively replace S-Voice, which in most phones, if you hold the home button, okay, on here we have Google, S-Voice will basically be replaced by Bixby, which is a more context-aware and content-aware voice assistant. Now, if I jump back to the user experience, both phones are running Android 7.0, but as you can see from the interfaces here, they are very different in their aesthetic style. There are definitely similarities, like the S Finder at the top. The Nougat update to the S7 and S7 Edge definitely brought in some new functionality that we've seen from the likes of the Note 7, but the aesthetic style of the icons, for example, of Samsung's own apps has now completely changed with the S8 Plus UI here. There's also the home button is also haptic feedback based, so you can have a full screen video running and still press that home button area and jump back to the home screen. So you lose no functionality despite not having a physical button there. Now, above those screens, we are looking at a 5-megapixel camera with a wide angle lens, f1.7 aperture on the S7 Edge, but on the S8 Plus, they've now upped the resolution to 8 megapixels. It also has face tracking, autofocus, and again has that nice wide f1.8 aperture, f1.7, excuse me. Either side of it as well, which you don't get, you just have the proximity and the brightness sensor up here on the S7 Edge, whoops. But on the S8 Plus, there's also now an optical iris scanner, which is an alternative to the fingerprint sensor for logging into the phone, which is a nice new feature. Now, if I jump around to the back of these devices, fingerprints are still abound, whichever hands that you pick, clearly. But you can see that as well as the fingerprint sensor, the flash, single LED flash, and the heart rate sensor have moved to the other side of the camera arrangement. And if I turn them to the profile view, you might be able to see that the S8 Plus's camera doesn't protrude anywhere near as much as the already pretty svelte S7 Edge's camera. So despite having an almost identical sensor setup, I believe it's a 12 megapixel sensor with optical image stabilization, electronic image stabilization, f1.7 aperture, dual focus pixel technology. It's just like the camera you get on the back of the S7 Edge, obviously with maybe some improved software and some improved image processing. But for the most part, it is the same tech in a thinner, more narrow package. So it just looks that little bit better. Running the show, I should say, performance-wise, we don't actually have at this pre-brief the exact process of running the S8 Plus here. But like the S7 and the S7 Edge, both phones share the same chipset, same memory, the S8 and the S8 Plus. So the S7 Edge that we have here is running on the Samsung's own Exynos 8890 processor with 4 GB of RAM and 32 GB of internal storage with microSD expandability. The S8 Plus features an octa-core Exynos chipset in the UK. In other markets, they might have the Qualcomm Snapdragon 835. And it's rumored to be or expected to be the 8895, Exynos 8895, but we'll be able to confirm that come the actual full launch of the phone. That's also paired to 4 GB of RAM, just like the S7 Edge, and 64 GB as the base level. So they've doubled the base storage over the S7 and S7 Edge, which is a nice improvement indeed. There's also, of course, microSD expandability, and that doesn't affect the IP68 water resistance. One thing where it's got smaller, however, is battery tech. You still get the fast charging, now over Type-C rather than micro USB to bring it up to date. And there is a headphone jack, I should mention as well, just like on the S7 Edge. But there's now a 3,500 mAh battery inside this larger S8 Plus, versus a 3,600 mAh battery in the S7 Edge. Now that's likely just down to the fact that the Android software is now more efficient, more power efficient, so you'll probably get around the same battery life. In our re-review of the S7 Edge, we were getting between a day and a half of use, depending on usage. And we're expecting much of the same, despite those extra pixels, with the S8 Plus and S8. So that is everything that I can think of off the top of my head right now. If you have any questions about either of these devices, you can drop us a line down below, and you can read the full comparison on recombi.com/mobile. Don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching.